I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. This rod right here that I showed you a while ago, that's what I'm going to grind off in little sections and use as my pegs that go through the four corners of my winder to keep the coils from where they can come off. Anyway, one thing I wanted to show you, when I cut these circles out on the skill saw, notice that edge is nice and beveled. And also you can see the lines where the blade passed going like this because it's round. It beveled it out pretty nice, which gave me a idea of something I never tried and I want to try. Doing it the Dan Rojas style, I'd have to say. This circle I could probably use for a VAWT. This is the outside piece. And it's a little thin towards the edges here. I'd probably use a bigger piece of plywood and play with that. But I'm thinking of casting my stator into this. Ought to pop out real easy. And if I really want to, I can grind the sides back down afterward.
Okay, I'm back. Notice the edge comes outside the line just a bit and outside the line over here just a bit. Take off these other pieces in the middle here first. And I want this wood to lay down flat. Another way to do that. Bring it down just a little bit and deburr it. Run it through. There we go, that ought to work. That one might be out a little bit far. So I'm going to look down the edge of this drill bit, and I'm going to see that it's outside the line from this direction. Then I'm going to look down this direction, adjust it this way. Same as the other one. Yeah, it's got it good. A little piece left. I'll file that afterward. It's good enough where to lay down flat. Now I get to do these corners. Looking down it this way to make sure it comes outside the line just a bit by going so far this way. And then I'm going to adjust it this way. That looks good. This is a 15/32 drill bit. Same diameter as my rod. That'll lay flat enough. That's cold. Line it up one way and line it up the other way. Up. A little bit too far that way. There we go. That's right on the money. I'll get that with a file. Alrighty. Now I'm going to stick this to the other two plates. Use these holes as guides. Line them up and drill them. I got to readjust.
Okay, I've raised this up. Notice this goes all the way down to where it just goes into the hole and past the hole. And this comes up. I got one, two, three layers. Plenty of room. So now let's do this. I'd rather do this one first because it has the lines where I can line this up straight. And I'll put a peg through the middle. Matter of fact, these middle holes need to be drilled because that was done with the other bit. Let's do that first.
Dead center, all of them. Looking good.
Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. As you can see right here, this is a piece of that rod that you saw with. And I'm going to go ahead and turn this and show you what I've done. I went ahead and ground down the side, leaving about a 90. I should have had the curve going this way, seeing as this rotates this way, but backwards works fine. But this drill here doesn't go in reverse. Anyway, because the other drill bit was just a little bit thinner than I wanted it to. See, that edge is still sharp right there. And basically I stuck the rod inside here. I took my angle grinder at an angle and held it there till I got a nice point, and then ground down carefully to make it go right to the tip. And so far, after sticking one more piece right here and a screw right here, a couple chips out here because I was pressing down a little hard, but it drilled right through. And you can see those pins are going to fit pretty snug, but they're going to fit straight and they're going to fit nice. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and take this down, and I'm going to go ahead and drill through the other part, and then I'm going to go ahead and drill through the other side with this together, which means I'm going to take this screw out or drill one from the other side in, and then push this pin through, flip it over, put the other piece on, and drive that other one in a little farther, and then I'll come right down these same holes and drill through the other one. And everything should line up and be straight. If you don't drill through here into here, your holes might not be in the same spot. They're going to be tight and wrong. So this is the main way to do it. Use this as your guide. Drill in, make sure holes, you know, all of these are lined up with the other ones. And then when I flip this over and put the other one on the other side, I'm going to drill right down through these holes and drill the other side of the form. Okay, as you see, I now have the other set up over here. I want this on this side. So basically, what I'm going to do is use the holes right here and set these down inside there. I got this one pushed up, so that's going to be all right. And all I got to do is find a place for this one to set as I put another screw from this side to keep this exactly where it's at, and then take this one out. And then I'll take that one from this side, from this side, and shove it right into this one. And I'll be right back in a minute. Okay, well, and now I got this screw in. You can see the hole from the other screw right there. And this, I'm just going to tap right on down into the other piece. There he is. Now it's all the way through. And I'm going to put this screw down the rest of the way. Not exactly all the way down. But they're real tight to each other. I'm sticking out the other side just a little bit. That sound you hear on this one,
That's a clutch. This is a screw gun. Sometimes it uses a little impact and everything. It's for doing drywall.
Doesn't just muscle it through. It puts it through with some vibration. All right, now it's time to drill this other one. I'll get that set up. All right, that should set us up. Let's drill a hole. Oop.
There we go.